Finally tonight, one of the perpetual challenges facing educators is finding ways to make school relevant in the lives of students. A school in Oakland, California has found success by designating lessons, making those links much closer between the classroom and the working world. The NewsHour's April Brown reports as part of our American Graduate Project. It's a public media initiative funded by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting.
Because there's a lot of fluid involved in giving birth.
This is probably not the kind of lesson you'd expect high school students to be getting.
Have them take a nice deep breath and hold it.
Learning side by side with emergency medical technicians in training about how to deliver a baby.
Hopefully we deliver one shoulder first, and baby is all the way out, okay?
Administering CPR. The best way to apply a tourniquet.
You're gonna put it 2 to 4 inches above the wound.
And how to check a patient's blood pressure.
On each other.
Getting a grasp on the basics of the medical profession is a large part of the curriculum at Life Academy of Health and Bioscience, a 6th through 12th grade public school in East Oakland, one of the poorest sections of the city.
91% of our kids are LCFF, or free and reduced lunch, all students of color, and most of their families have been educated up to about 6th grade.
Preston Thomas is the principal at Life Academy, which was founded in 2001 with the goal of preparing low-income and minority students for health science careers.
It is very important that patient information remains on paper and between you and the doctor.
The school uses an educational approach often found in more affluent districts, known as linked learning. The model integrates academics with career-based training and a workplace environment.
We have kids that go to every major hospital in Oakland, and they're starting to take some of the real-world practical skills that they're learning on the internships, but also the things that we're talking about in class, and they're starting to synthesize that into the vision that they see for themselves.
The nearly 500 students here pick one of three career pathways: medicine, mental health, or biotechnology. Many of them, including Jorge Ruiz, complete a 2.5-year internship with Children's Hospital in Oakland, rotating through different departments and taking field trips to places like Fast Response, where they learned about what happens during childbirth. Ruiz, a senior, is already using his training outside the classroom, helping his mom take care of his two sisters.
My two older sisters are both disabled. My oldest, her name is Stephanie. She has cerebral palsy. And then my second older sister, Liliana, has cerebral palsy quadriplegia. She feeds through a G-tube. And so then that kind of piqued a small interest.
In addition to the linked learning approach, Life Academy also created a student-centered learning environment, which means the schoolwork is collaborative, challenging, relevant, and connected to real-life situations.
With Social Security, driver's license, and a work permit. Cool.
This year, Sunil Kaluri's 12th grade government class is discussing police interactions in minority communities and President Barack Obama's executive action on immigration. Those are issues that affect many of his students, including Ruiz, whose father was deported to Mexico.
When he was deported, I never really had a chance to say goodbye. It happened in the morning when he was going off to work, and then the story is that some people pulled over and then they took him.
When you engage kids what's happening now, it's so much more real, it's so much more alive, and it makes them so much more excited about politics in ways that talking about something 3 years ago that I developed in my third year of teaching won't.
But it's the school's primary focus on health careers that struck a personal chord with junior Andrea Sigala.
My mom, she's an alcoholic, and she's been an alcoholic for her whole life, and she's been hospitalized. And when I would love to help people who struggle with that too.
Even though studies have shown linked learning and student-centered learning can improve achievement, the challenges of everyday life can sometimes be too difficult to deal with. That's why the teachers here also serve as advisors, who stay with students through their entire career at Life Academy, helping them overcome both educational and personal obstacles. Annie Hatch teaches humanities and English and is Andrea Sigala's advisor.
Every time she sees me, like if I look sad or anything, she asks me what's wrong, and I know I can count on her and tell her anything, and she won't like go tell anybody else.
I just think this is a place where she's felt comfortable expressing, you know, her struggles, and also I think she feels really supported by her classmates and her teachers.
Students like Sigala were admitted to Life Academy through an open enrollment lottery. And like other Oakland schools, Its financial support comes largely from district funds. However, results here have been remarkable in a city where only half of African American and Latino students graduate from high school and even fewer enroll in college.
Students are being prepared for college and career together. So in the past, we've had two tracks. You can be college prep or you can be career, and that was auto shop or home ec or things like that. But now we're talking about really preparing kids for professional careers where the two are integrated.
Diane Friedlander is a senior researcher at Stanford University. She recently oversaw a study on Life Academy. The report showed that among Oakland's public high schools, Life Academy has the second highest rate of graduates who go on to attend four-year universities. That, Friedlander believes, is because the school makes the benefits of learning clear to students, even though all the options in a regular school, like sports and many electives, aren't offered here. That was originally a concern for Sigala.
I do miss that. Like, I used to be in theater. I used to, love acting. But now that I know what I want to do, I know that I want to be a doctor or somewhere in the medical field, I don't miss it as much.
The Stanford report also notes two other elements that have helped students succeed here: engaging parents and building partnerships within the community. Life Academy holds weekly meetings for parents to get updates on how their kids are doing, and it has several health and biotech businesses in Oakland now participating, providing both internships and career counseling to students. Shanta Ramdahal manages the student internship program at Children's Hospital, and she believes her program is also working to grow a more diverse workforce of local caregivers.
If we don't do it, it's a missed opportunity. Just imagine, for doctors who go on to medical school, what these kids are doing today, it takes 2 years in medical school before they will start shadowing medical providers or doing certain things that these students are doing today. So it opens up a new world for them.
But Stanford's Diane Friedlander warns against trying to create exact replicas because it's taken years to get buy-in from everyone involved.
Those core ideas can definitely and should definitely be replicated in other places, but to take it as a kind of cookie cutter model and put it down in another site won't work. There won't be ownership. It won't be connected to that community.
But in East Oakland, Principal Thomas has found these opportunities are motivating kids to continue their education so they can get the jobs they really want.
We really want students and families to have the opportunity to attend college, and not just you've qualified for it, but that you can really succeed it and make it through those 4 years of college, which are really rigorous and really challenging for students that don't have any frameworks for understanding what college is going to be like because they're the first.
Thus far, California has 9 districts across the state using linked learning, and the city of Oakland recently approved a measure that will help create more linked learning opportunities in its schools over the next 10 years. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm April Brown in Oakland, California.